A focus trap is a very important accessibility feature within a web application. In this video, I'll first help you understand what it is, then why it's important, and finally, I'll show you how to quickly and easily add the concept within your Angular apps where needed. And it's pretty easy thanks to the Angular CDK. All right, let's get to it. Accessibility can be a little difficult to understand or even think about if you're someone who can see, hear, and use the web easily with different devices. So it can also be easy to build things that don't work well for those who can't. A focus trap is a feature that helps make experiences better for these folks. It's a way of managing user focus within a given container. Take, for example, a modal. If a user opens a modal without managing focus, when they start navigating via the keyboard by using the tab key, items behind the modal continue to receive focus. This is weird and not what the user would expect, right? We need to programmatically focus them within the modal. But this isn't enough. If we stop here, as we tab through the modal, eventually we'll tab through all of the focusable items and then we'll be back to focusing items within the original document again while the modal is still open. What we need to do instead is trap the focus so that when the user focuses on the last item, focus will be placed back on the first focusable element on the next tab. Okay, so now that we know what a focus trap is, we're probably beginning to realize that there's going to be some effort to create this functionality, right? Well, not within Angular. With the CDK, this is pretty easy using the trap focus directive. Let's look at an example. Here we have a web app for the Vans shoe brand. Up here at the top, we have a sign up button. When we click it and then tab around, we can see focus is moving around the items in the background. Not what we want, right? Okay, let's add the trap focus directive. First thing we need to do in order to use it is we need to import the Ally module. For those of you who are unfamiliar with this acronym, Ally is an abbreviation for the word accessibility. It comes from the concept that the word begins with an A and ends with a Y, and there are 11 characters in between. The CDK has several accessibility features within their accessibility module, and the trap focus directive is one of them. So once we have it imported, we can now use it within the template. We just need to add it to an element that wraps our form. Okay, now let's try our signup form again. Bummer. It looks like even though we've added the directive, we still need to programmatically add focus to our modal container when it's opened. Well, more good news. The focus trap directive has this feature built right in. We can use the trap focus AutoCapture input. This input will automatically focus the first focusable item within the directive when it's initialized. It defaults to false, so we need to provide a value of true. Okay, now let's try it one more time. There, now the name field is focused when it's opened. And we can tab through. Now, when we get to the close button, we'll cycle back to the name field. Also, if we hit shift tab to navigate backwards, we'll go in reverse order, all without leaving the modal. So not only is this super helpful for all users really, but it's super easy to implement too. One last thing to note, the trap focus directive keeps track of the last focused element before its initialization. So when we close the modal, the focus is returned to the button that opened it. Nice. We just saved a ton of work and made our modal much more accessible. All right, I think that's it for now. Until next time, thanks for watching.